somewhere along the line, before we started itself, we realized that the market isn't just fridge magnets or souvenirs or stuff like that. We said with, you know, a large enough lifestyle and accessories kind of company is something that we'd like to build. And we did that for about close to, when we launched finally in March 2010, we did that for about 2 years, two and a half years, saying that let's put the word out there, let's get an online website, let's put, you know, go through distributed stores such as Shopper Stop and Crossword and the mom and pop stores across the country.
And that's the genesis of what became a magnetic start to one of the most popular lifestyle brands in the country. Chumbak, which is present in Bengaluru, Mumbai and Delhi, is galloping ahead. It was the overwhelming response and customer feedback that got Chumbak to get out into the market with pop-up stores and finally create their flagship stores. This also meant innovation and creation of a larger product line.
In 2012, we realized that one of the biggest pieces of feedback that we got from consumers was, you know, we love Chumbak, we love seeing it in all these places, but show me a place where I can see all of Chumbak in one location. So I think that's when we decided that let's experiment with a small kiosk kind of format, about 200, 250 kind of square feet, in, you know, large traffic areas such as malls, where we decided that if we experiment and let's try out one. So the first one we tried out was in Forum in Bangalore, where we decided let's put up all the Chumbak products that we have. Let's control the kind of look and feel that's there of the kiosk itself. So I think that did really well. Somewhere we decided that customers want a lot more of Chumbak in terms of what kind of products that they're using.
Chumbak simultaneously began putting its efforts in the online segment as well. And soon, from a 15 to 20 member team, today it has over 350 employees in three cities. Chumbak continues to reinvent itself every day through a continuous learning curve. Tracking the Indian art scene, then Seher Zaman's face would be familiar. Apology Gallery, started by Paul Fernandez, takes you back in time to Bangalore in the 70s,